Hey, this is David CC11 Evolution. Welcome to my channel. We're going to explore this video titled, What's the Real Identity of an African American? Created by Dane Calloway, Danity Kane Calloway, I don't know. Anyway, let's start this video, shall we? But before we get into the video, I wanted to make a response video because of the toxic nature of this whole We Aint African movement going on. I'm not saying that it has a big following, but it's starting to get out of control with how narratively stupid and dumb this is starting to get. My point is not to not outright embarrass the man or so-called winning an argument with this guy, because you can't really win an argument in this case, because you can't beat a shepherd if he is a leader of sheep. But what you can do is put ignorance on display for everyone to see. I decided to make this video for those reasons and those reasons alone. To me, this is worse than white supremacy. This is self-supremacy, and it's very cancerous and toxic to African Americans to believe this nonsense. I'm pretty sure it's getting pushed by the Black Hebrew Israelites. It only makes sense that they would warrant their own self-destruction, given they promote a foreign book that has caused more harm to our people than anything else. But with further ado, let's just get into the video and let's just check it out and see what all this shit's about.
Log on to patreon.com/Dane Calloway or paypal.me/Dane Calloway to support me, my channel, and my...
This man advertising his PayPal account at the beginning of his video. I have no problem with Patreon. A lot of these YouTubers got to make money some way. But I find that interesting. He might as well have put his Cash App down. In fact, we're going to stop this video and make a public announcement for all my supporters. Please send me money at #, grab booty cheeks, We Aint African 200.
By demand, merchandise is now available at imjustheretomakeyouthink.com.
Man, brother man got his own merchandise. He got his own merch. I'm just here to make you think. We're going to get back to that one.
My word to all black Americans, one thing I would like to say, let's not be deceived. Look at the record. Look at the promises that have been made over the past from the Democratic Party.
On this day, it is also the bicentennial of Charles Darwin's birth. It's worth a moment to pause and renew that commitment to science and innovation.
So let's jump right into the next question.
You haven't even asked the question yet, nor have you given an answer to the initial question.
And it's so if we shouldn't call ourselves African Americans or black, then what should we call ourselves? And that is a very good question.
The problem with his question is, or his line of thinking is, he's trying to get his viewers to dismiss any African connection that can be associated with our heritage. He's purposely trying to do that. You can see it throughout this whole video.
All right, now if you take a look at my previous documentaries, I explained, or shared rather, detailed information as to the reason why you should not call yourself nor associate yourself with those dangerous terms.
The only dangerous thing in this video is you, nigga. You are endangering brain cells.
You are indigenous to this land, not anywhere else, this land.
I am indigenous. I am Native American. Shut your stupid ass up, dog. God damn. But on a serious note, pay close attention to the whole Charles Darwin thing, because that's just a way of them trying to take the science element out so you can never prove that we are Africans. That's basically what that's about, essentially.
Little island, now known as North America.
Let's keep switching the identity to hide the people. Why don't we just keep renaming you? Are you Negro? Oh, no, you're not Negro. No, you're colored. No. You're not colored. You're African American. And this is what they name you. The slavers name you this. Because I know a white guy who grew up in South Africa. And he now lives in America. He is an African American, and more African American than most. Do you see how African American is a misnomer? It's a misnomer. Don't check that box. It's a title given to blacks by democratic slaves.
These are how crooks operate. They operate under the umbrella that they know what they're talking about when they don't. Truth isn't meant for everyone to hear, because it sure as hell ain't meant for you. We're going to do a little experiment. We're going to do the whole creepy music thing. We're just going to have a picture of tacos and see how it works. We Aboriginal. We the original man. We made tacos. We invented Taco Tuesday. Them dirty fucking Europeans, man. They took our tacos. They took our motherfucking tacos and made us, cause we indigenous! We indigenous, motherfucker!
Now, in today's society of America, millions of so-called African Americans are struggling to come to grips with their true identity, culture, heritage, and history, mainly due to the numerous manipulative tactics utilized to govern their critical thinking mechanisms and to also decimate their literacy capabilities. Each one of these manipulative social engineering experiments can only be detected and detached from one's subconscious when standing outside of the box.
This dude ain't telling you to be cognizant of your history. He's telling you to look everywhere else. This shit can't be exploring consciousness. This shit leaves you straight unconscious and ignorant. It's kind of hard when you're promoting yourself as some type of conscious person. I'm trying to make you think when you actually keeping your viewers boxed in.
I'll let you ponder on what's happening to those that are still inside of it. Meanwhile, you have not and will not ever hear me promote any form of religion throughout any of my content that I present to the public. Reason being is due to religion, faith, and beliefs are based on one's personal relationships and not relationships. And I am not here to debate nor argue about who you should or should not love. That's simply none of my business. So let's also be sure not to confuse the truth that I present throughout my content with any personal beliefs that you may have. Now in this segment, you will learn about who you truly are and where you really came from based on truthful information. Because mind you, there is a big difference between truth and facts. Facts is merely controversial information, whereas a person bears the opinion to debate its credibility or not. That's yet another form of belief. Whereas truth is non-debatable due to its credibility of always making logical sense. This is why in today's society, most people don't even care about the truth. Why? Because to them, unfortunately, a lie is more entertaining.
This man is a mad projectionist, ain't he?
Now, on March 1st, 1790, then-President George Washington and Vice President John Adams, along with then-Speaker of the House Frederick Muhlenberg, signed the 1790 Census Act. According to the census itself, it states that the 1790 Census Act is a law that, quote, required that every household be visited, that completed census schedules be posted in two of the most public places within each jurisdiction, there to remain for the inspection of all concerned, and that the aggregated amount of each description of persons for every district be transmitted to the president. So let me point out that some households, not all,
were visited by these individuals entitled as census enumerators, also known as census takers, who are technically federally government unsupervised employees who allegedly went from town to town, city to city, and door to door, deciding who was of what race, and then documented the families they meet as such. So you mean to tell me that these census takers were provided instructions by way of the government to document and record the ethnic category of various family members based on their perception of the family when they visited, and their opinions were considered to be official historical records of information?
Native Americans were never counted as Americans because they weren't a part of the country of America. So that's for one. Secondly, America, the country, was established in 1776, so yes, a demographic and a census would probably be important to this new country. But what about the Three-Fifths Compromise? Why mention an act that passed in 1790, but gloss over something that was passed 3 years prior? The Three-Fifths Compromise passed in 1787. One of the main reasons why the Three-Fifths Compromise passed was because in Europe, a child could inherit lands through his father. Since Europeans were having a rape fest in the Americas with their slaves, like fucking crazy, they had to put a stop to that.
Even though they did not count every individual living within the United States due to the multiple indigenous Niji raids and rebellions occurring during this time period, the alleged first official census of the entire United States was implemented on a day dubbed as Census Day on August 2nd, 1790. See, now, what's very important to note here is that the, quote, free people of color were recorded all in one group.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man? Bro, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
Stop it. Get some help.